Welcome to a video. The topic is operations with complex numbers, and the goals are to add, subtract, multiply, and divide complex numbers. We'll start off by talking about adding and subtracting complex numbers. If you take a look at the rule for adding and subtracting complex numbers, it looks like there's a lot going on, but really, it's pretty much the same as combining like terms. Each complex number has a real part and an imaginary part. If you're adding two complex numbers, you add the real parts together, and then you add the imaginary parts together. And if we have a difference of complex numbers, we find the difference of the real parts and the difference of the imaginary parts. So if we take a look at number one, 3 plus 4i plus 7 minus 5i, 3 and 7 are the real parts, and 4i and negative 5i are the imaginary parts. What that means is we can add 3 plus 7, or the real parts, and we can also add 4i plus negative 5i. The result will be 10 plus 4i plus negative 5i would be negative 1i or negative i, but this is normally written as 10 minus i. We follow a similar process for subtraction. Since we're subtracting now, we'll subtract the real parts and subtract the imaginary parts. So we'll have negative 2 minus negative 4 plus 7i minus a positive 7i. So the result, negative 2 minus negative 4 becomes negative 2 plus 4, or positive 2, plus 0i, which is just 0, so the result is 2. So as you can see, it's pretty much just like combining like terms. Now let's talk about multiplying complex numbers. We will multiply complex numbers just like we would multiply two binomials together. We'll multiply a times the quantity c plus di, then we'll multiply bi times the quantity c plus di. Then we'll combine like terms and simplify. So let's go ahead and give it a try. Here we'd have 6 minus 8i. Then we'd have 9i minus 12i squared. Now remember, a complex number is the form of a plus bi, so we can't leave I squared in this product, so we'll replace I squared with negative 1. So we'll have negative 12 times negative 1, that'll be positive 12. Then we have a positive 6, so that'll give us 18. And then we have a negative 8i plus 9i, would give us a positive 1i, or just plus i. On number 2, there's no shortcuts. We have to write this out as 5 minus 2i times 5 minus 2i. Go ahead and multiply as we normally would. So we'll have 25 minus 10i minus 10i again. And then lastly, we're going to have negative 2i times negative 2i will be positive 4i squared. Well, again, I squared is equal to negative 1, so 4 times negative 1 is negative 4. Combining negative 4 with 25, we'll have 21. Combining negative 10i minus 10i, only minus 20i. Now, this last product is a special product. It's called the product of complex conjugates. Notice the terms are the same. One's a sum and one's a difference. We have 7 plus 2i and 7 minus 2i. The product of these two complex numbers should be real. 7 times 7 is 49. 7 times negative 2i is minus 14i. 2i times 7 is plus 14i. And then lastly, we have negative 4i squared. And what's special here is that the imaginary parts of these complex numbers are opposites. So these have a sum of 0. I squared is negative 1, so negative 4 times negative 1 is positive 4, plus 49 is equal to 53. Now let's go ahead and check these on the graphing calculator. If we press the mode key and you scroll down to here, make sure you have A plus BI selected. That way the calculator will recognize complex numbers. Go back to the home screen and we'll check 1, 2, and 3. 2 plus 3i. I is located by pressing second decimal. 18 plus I is what we had for number 1. Let's go ahead and check number 2. We have the quantity 5 minus 2i squared. And that checks. And the last one we had 53, let's check that. We had 7 plus 2i times 7 minus 2i. And that checks as well. Let's now talk about powers of I. Now, some textbooks talk about dividing by 4, and then there's 4 different cases. But to me, as long as you can remember that I squared is equal to negative 1, you should be able to figure out logically what all these are equal to. This is what I mean by that. We want to determine how many I squareds are in I to the fifth. Well, one way to think of that is how many 2's are in 5. Well, there are 2 2's in 5. 2 times 2 would be 4, with one extra factor of I. Now we'll just replace I squared with negative 1. Negative 1 squared is positive 1 times I, so the result is I. If I is raised to an odd power, the result will always be I or negative I. Let's take a look at number 2. How many I squareds are in I to the 24th power? Or how many 2's are in 24? Well, there's 12 2's in 24. This is the same as I to the 24th. We now replace I squared with negative 1. Negative 1 to the 12th power is positive 1. So if we have I raised to an even power, it will always be either 1 or negative 1. Let's go ahead and try one more. How many I squareds are in I to the 35th? If we raise this to the 17th power, that would be I to the 34th with an extra factor of I. Now we have negative 1 to the 17th power times I. Well, a negative number raised to an odd power will always be negative. So we have negative 1 times I or negative I. Let's go ahead and finish by talking about the division of complex numbers. We will first write the problem in fractional form, and then we will rationalize the denominator by multiplying the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator. In order to divide these two complex numbers, we must multiply by the conjugate of the denominator in both the numerator and denominator. So the conjugate of 5 minus 3i is 5 plus 3i. So we'll multiply the numerator by the same thing. Remember, the product of these conjugates should be a real number. So let's go ahead and multiply the denominator first. 5 times 5, that would be 25. The next two products should be opposites. Here we have a positive 15i, and then we have a negative 15i. Those would simplify out, and the last product is negative 9i squared. Now let's go ahead and multiply the numerator. We have 20 plus 12i plus 10i. plus 6i squared. Let's simplify this. We know that I squared is negative 1, so negative 9 times negative 1 is positive 9, plus 25, that would give us 34. In the numerator, this would end up being a negative 6, since I squared is negative 1, so 20 plus negative 6 would be 14, and then 12i plus 10i would be 22i. Let's write this in a plus bi form and then simplify. So we'd have 14 over 34 plus 22 over 34i. This simplifies to 7 17ths plus 11 17ths i. This is a lot of work. Let's go ahead and check this one on the calculator. Numerator was 4 plus 2i. Denominator was 5 minus 3i. Let's convert this to fraction notation by pressing math, enter, enter. And we have 7 17ths plus 11 17ths i. And that's exactly what we had as well. Okay, on this last problem, our denominator is 2i. You can think of 2i as 0 plus 2i. Therefore, the conjugate would be 0 minus 2i, or just negative 2i. So multiply both the numerator and denominator by negative 2i, and we'll simplify. So our denominator would be negative 4i squared. Our numerator would be negative 10i. Again, I squared is negative 1, so negative 1 times negative 4 would be positive 4 over negative 10i. This would be negative 5 halves i. Okay, I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.